Game companies are out to make good games, right?
Wrong.
If that was the only reason, then explain to me Pac-Man on the 2600, Bubsy 3D, or even a very recent one like the day before. Companies are out to make a good game because it's gonna sell, making them money. It's the backbone of any business out there. Well, I never said they all got the memo. One thing that all companies must do is promote. Some go all in, and sometimes, well, let's just say that things get past the common sense department, quality assurance, and decency filters for some unknown reason. This video, let's take a look at marketing promotions from game companies. Some good, but oh, so many bad ones. So many. Grab some popcorn, folks, because some of this stuff is so crazy that you're gonna think that I'm making it up, but trust me, it's real. Except this ad here where it shows Stevie Wonder promoting the Atari 2600. Yeah, this isn't real. It's not real. It never happened. But it is funny. Let's start off with one of my favorite promotions of all time, even if it was left incomplete. The Sword Quest series by Atari. Four games were to be released on the Atari 2600 to coincide with this promotion. Earthworld, Fireworld, Waterworld, and finally Airworld. This was a big ambitious project that spanned across not only the games but into comics as well. Each title came with a small comic book that delved into the storyline in more detail and was penciled by the late but amazing, great George Perez, one of my favorite comic book artists ever. Each game had hidden clues, and those clues will point you to certain comic book pages where you will eventually come across words that could make a sentence, and you had to somehow decipher the real ones from the fake ones to solve the puzzle. You were then supposed to mail your findings, and Atari would crown one winner for each title. Prizes were gonna be actual artifacts made out of gold and silver, among other fancy trinkets. A talisman, a crown, a chalice, and a philosopher's stone were the prizes at stake, one for each game and each valued at $25,000 each. The final four winners would compete at Atari headquarters for the chance to win this bad boy right here. A gold-handled sword that was valued at around $50,000. I'm going to be covering this promotion in the near future in much more detail, but here is a short version of it. Atari did what Atari does best, and that was f***ed up. In short, Atari lost $350 million in 1983 alone. And you might be asking yourself, well, what does that have to do with the promotion? Well, when that happened, Warner sold Atari to Jack Tramiel, and then he pretty much killed the Atari brand pretty slowly in the coming years. This promotion was stopped just short of completion. Airworld was the only game out of the four not to be released or even finished officially. Same for the comic book. But the prizes alone make this promotion one of the most amazing video game lores possibly of all time. Except for the part where Atari just ruined it at the end. Nintendo just killed Sega during the 8-bit console wars. So when Sega came out swinging for the fences during the 16-bit era and really gave Nintendo a run for its money, it was a good thing for gamers everywhere. The Sega Does What Nintendon't advertising promotion was a thing of beauty. Sega took the lead into the 16-bit era and made Nintendo pay for their slow entry to the next generation. Even Nintendo fanboys got a chuckle out of this. Come on, you know you guys did. The commercials were great, the ads were everywhere, and this slogan is still one of my favorite of all time.
What Nintendo? The 16-bit Genesis system by Sega. Genesis does it all.
Mortal Kombat! I was never a huge Mortal Kombat fan in the arcades, but when the game was set to come out in the home consoles, gamers everywhere lost their freaking minds. The advertising was everywhere. It was a massive undertaking, reportedly costing around $10 million. The game was released on September 13, which came to be known as Mortal Monday, and it reimagined how video games advertising should be done. The console versions went on to sell millions of copies, and audio snippets from the commercial would be used for the main theme of the Mortal Kombat movie that arrived in 1995. Sega was almost neck and neck with Nintendo during the 16-bit era. They had a good system. The Sega CD added new functionality, and their marketing was spot on for the most part. And then they released the 32X. And suddenly gamers were worried and confused, mostly scared. I mean, look at this thing. The next generation was just around the corner. How would Sega respond to their entry to the 32-bit world? Could they just reset and enter the new generation on a clean slate? The Sega Saturn released in Japan in November 22 of 1994, a few weeks before the PlayStation, and it came packed in with Virtua Fighter, one of the most popular 3D fighting games of its time. It was a good move, and the Saturn sold extremely well into the holiday of that year, edging out the PlayStation in Japan. So the launch in the US would be just as good, right? Right. Hello? Anybody? Oh crap. Tom Kalinske, Sega of America's president back then, announced the Saturn release on March of 1995, stating it would be unleashed into the US market on Saturn Day, September 2 of 1995. I'm not making that up. The problem is that Sega of Japan didn't want to wait that long and wanted it released earlier to get a head start on the PlayStation. During E3 of that year, the Saturn was presented and advertised with a $399 launch price bundled with Virtua Fighter. Tom Kalinske stated that due to high demand, the Saturn would launch early in May instead of September. The real reason though, it was that Sega of Japan pushed for that early release date. Problem is that the distributors were also blindsided by this announcement. And not only that, Sega totally left out Walmart and Best Buy out of the launch loop. They left out the largest retailer in the United States and one of the biggest electronic stores of that time for the Saturn launch. Okay, what were you guys smoking? Then to top it all off, Sony followed up the Saturn's presentation with the price point heard around the world. $299. Yep, it was that subtle, but you can almost hear it. The sound of Sega dying. JRPGs were slow gaining traction in the US after many great hits on the Super NES. So Final Fantasy VII was a big deal. One, it had been exclusive to Nintendo, but was now on the new Sony console after it was dropped on the N64. And two, it was semi-3D with pre-rendered backgrounds. The marketing promotion that followed was massive, as JRPGs were still trying to break off from that small niche here in the West. Thanks to the successful marketing and overall sales of Final Fantasy VII, more publishers and developers were willing to bring their titles over to our side. So, in a way, Final Fantasy VII opened the door for all other RPGs and allowed us gamers to experience such titles that we would have otherwise missed out on. I would say this is a win-win for all. Thanks, Final Fantasy. However, not all marketing is good, and the claim is about to show us why. First up is their promotion for Burnout 2. They advertised that they were willing to reimburse any driver that got a speeding ticket in the UK on the game's release date. So good job there, Acclaim, for promoting speeding, putting in danger the lives of everyone on the road. And how would they do this actually? What criteria was needed to qualify for that reimbursement? Did they need to show that they had bought the copy of Burnout 2, or were they just supposed to get a speeding ticket on the day of the launch? You know, we never found out, because you know why? Eventually, the promotion was cancelled. However, the monkeys that were running rampant in the marketing department were not done yet. They had another brilliant idea, yeah, believe it or not. And by brilliant, I mean totally devoid of any decency. That same year, they decided to promote the release of Shadow Man 2 by promising to pay for advertising space aimed at the game if they were placed on actual tombstones. I am not making this up. Oh no, but wait, they weren't done here yet. They then made some remarks that poor families could take advantage of this promotion since it would help offset the cost of burying a loved one. How thoughtful. And all you needed to do was advertise a little bit of that sweet, sweet game called Shadow Man 2 on the PS2. Oh, Acclaim, you so crazy. The Dead or Alive series was created by Tecmo after seeing the Virtua Fighter games explode into mainstream gaming. They wanted a piece of that pie, and they added many interesting characters and spruced up some, how can I put this, mechanics along the way. The series creator himself stated that it was always intended to be provocative, and when Dead or Alive 3 came out, well, just watch.
Well, I only play for the fighting. I appreciate the expansive multi-tier environments and the 16 characters with the pixel shading bump mapping. And the rich plot development. Seriously, why else would I play it? She kicks eye.
Rated T for teen.
Then Tecmo said to themselves, that is not provocative enough. Let's take out the men from the equation and the fighting mechanics and focus on the women in a setting befitting of their gender. A Dead or Alive cooking game? You sexist pig, you're fired. Put them in a beach setting in skimpy bikinis and up the jiggling engine on their boobs? Give this man right here a raise. Dead or Alive Extreme Beach Volleyball was created and, well, the commercial says it all.
Rated M for mature.
Hey!
Play with a friend, or play with yourself. Dead or Alive Extreme Beach Volleyball. Tecmo. 100% games.
For hot beaches, there's no power greater than X.
There's a sports segment thrown in there somewhere, but I have no idea what it is. You'd think Tecmo would back down a bit, but nah. The Dead or Alive franchise is still going strong. Moving on. Halo had taken the gaming world by surprise on the original Xbox. After the amazing response Bungie got from Part 2, which was awesome by the way, Halo 3 had some high expectations to meet. The Halo 3 Belief trailer is still considered by many to be a high point not only in advertising, but in artistic vision. No over-the-top CGI, no gameplay is shown, just a depiction of a massive firefight and Master Chief ready to fight to the end. Next up is this PSP advertisement. You know what? Let's just move on from this one. This next entry was very controversial. I mean, just the game alone is controversial. But the advertising campaign was either brilliant or heresy depending on what side of the aisle you're standing on. Dante's Inferno is a game that deals with the main character traveling through the realms of hell on his quest to save his wife. The game alone has very violent imagery and action set pieces. EA, the publisher of the game, however, went on an all-out campaign to promote this game, and it kind of feels like they were having some fun at the expense of, I don't know, religion, common sense, decent people, decency all around. Let's take a look at the discount pricing first. EA had a one-day promotion with GameStop. If you pre-ordered the game on September 9 of 2009, you got a $6.66 discount off retail cost. They also sent out $200 checks to a couple of game critics from around the US. And the check basically stated this. Greed is hoarding avarice. He who clutches the golden coins with a closed fist closes his heart to divine grace. Greed is wasting prodigality. He who squanders wealth allows the first fruits owed to heaven to rot on the vine. So basically, if you cash the check, you go to hell. And if you keep the check, you're still going to hell. Gee, thanks so much, EA. And by the way, the wooden box that they were delivered in, they look simply amazing. There was also a website that was created specifically for a fake religious-based video game called Mass, We Pray. I was able to find it on the Wayback Machine. The website talks about a game where you can pretend to be at church, and it promotes it as a game that allows you to also enjoy Sunday services any day of the week. Check out the video that they created for it.
A family shouldn't have to wait until Sunday to worship the Lord.
Amen.
Now you can go to church every day without leaving your home. Introducing Mass, We Pray. The wireless cross controller detects movement in three dimensions. Every twist of the hand and nuance of a blessing is recreated on screen. Use it to participate in more than 24 unique and exhilarating ceremonies. Be sure to try them all. The more you play, the more grace points you collect. Then, trade in your grace points to unlock the holy mysteries. Add the kneeler accessory and get off the couch and into the action. To extend the experience, download the Seven Sacraments and Holy Rituals expansion pack. Featuring Ash Wednesday, Conduct the Choir, Transubstantiation, Taking Collection, Holy Matrimony, Holy Procession, Genuflecting, and many more. Bring your family closer to heaven. Mass We Pray. Only by PrayerWorks Interactive.
Holy sh! Okay, my bad, wrong choice of words. If you click to order the game, it opened up this page calling you a heretic, but hey, you can order the game and be a heretic with a copy of Dante's Inferno. Then people started to protest the game outside the EA office building. After news coverage brought this to the public's attention, EA came out and admitted to paying these performers to protest the game to give it more exposure. Oh, but wait, I'm not done. And neither was EA. They then sent a few wooden boxes marked Inferno to some publication writers. If they opened the box up, the Rick Astley song Never Gonna Give You Up would play.
Talking. I like the little bones.
It will continue to play the song over and over until the box was destroyed and you got to the inside part where you can disconnect the batteries. It came with a hammer and goggles for this purpose. Once the box is destroyed, there is a small note inside letting you know that you had committed the sin of wrath and were damned to hell. Then there was the Super Bowl commercial that played the song Ain't No Sunshine by Bill Withers as cutscenes of the game were shown. I can't make this stuff up. Then there was another website made up to promote a book called The Panther System, showing you how to become a master at stealing the women from other men. If you clicked on a link on the page, it would tell you that you had committed treachery and will be cast onto hell. I could only find very basic screenshots here on the Wayback Machine. All these stunts caused lots of negative feedback from consumers and even religious circles. But even then, you have to admit that was some crazy marketing promotion. Someone is going to hell for all that, that's for sure. Aside from Dante, of course. With terrorism being a very real and dangerous side to the reality we all live in, it is unclear as to who greenlit this next promotion or who even thought it was a good idea overall. Yet Ubisoft decided to mail these small safes to various video game outlets. However, one ended up in 9MSN, and a note was attached to it telling them to check their voicemail. Here's the problem. 9MSN did not do game reviews, and two, it had no idea where the safe came from. When they tried to open it up, it started making a beeping noise. Naturally, the police and bomb squad were called and the building was evacuated. When police opened the box, they found a copy of Watch Dogs. In a world where terrorism is a real thing, this right here was no laughing matter, and Ubisoft quickly apologized and stated that the delivery of the safe did not go as planned. No shit! Now, these here were a few examples of ads and promotions that were either done right or just went off the rails so badly that some might either find funny while others might find as more serious and no laughing matter. There are tons more bad promotions and ads out there, but what are some of the worst ones that you have seen? Or what are some of the best? Share with us your thoughts and be back here for my 100th video, where I will be covering a game genre so massive and so sprawling, it might be the longest video yet. And for that, I apologize. Until then, keep watching and keep gaming.
It's blood.
EA Games.